You see tires everywhere as they move the world around us, but you probably didn't realize how much thoughtful engineering is needed to make one and how much better tires have gotten in the last 70 years. For example, scientists figured out how a few clever tweaks to tread geometry made tires way quieter. As well, the shops and tools that service them have also been transformed. I found the Apple of tire machines, which has become so automated that even a child can put a wheel on a tire. However, it's not all rainbows and unicorns. I discovered this sneaky engineering move that some companies can use to cheat in tire reviews. My name is Andrew, and let's discover the cool design and engineering behind these boring products.
Wait a minute. Before we go on, I want to thank our sponsor, NordVPN. You might have heard NordVPN provides a secure tunnel to many countries around the world so you can watch international streaming content and protect your own privacy. As a Nord user, I wanted to know that they weren't spying on me. Well, I did some digging and found they hired PwC, an independent auditor, to analyze and evaluate that no logs were being stored. Who's PwC? They're part of the big four accounting firms who are trusted to judge that companies like Ford and PayPal are telling the truth about their financial statements. PwC interviewed Nord employees and inspected servers to assure that no logs of user activities were being kept. Nord passed the audit, which improves my trust in their services. I also use Nord to prevent my internet access from being blocked while using public Wi-Fi. If you ever seen this message while at a cafe, library, or school, you know how frustrating it is. With Nord, I can get around those blocks through the encrypted servers. So to protect your privacy and remove restrictions, go to nordvpn.com/lamb and get a 73% discount on a 2-year plan. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee, and you help support this channel. The link is nordvpn.com/lamb. It's in the description, and let's get back to our story on innovation.
This is a socket, and it's used to tighten or remove bolts that hold things like wheels to your car. If you look closely, all the corners are rounded, and the reason is fascinating. We need to go back to the 1960s to learn why.
During the Vietnam War, aircraft mechanics faced a serious issue. When they tried to remove tightly fastened bolts, they would round off, which means the shape went from being a hexagon to a circle. The reason is that sockets back then had sharp corners, which grabbed the bolts at its points, which under high torque could shear them off. Snap-on, a high-end tool brand, came to the rescue. The solution was to round the socket's corners, which moved the nut's contact point to the edges, which are more resilient to damage. It worked. Mechanics could work faster and get airplanes into the sky. In 1966, this design was patented, sold to the public under the name Flank Drive, and is still being made today. After the patent expired in 1987, this tech trickled down into every company socket, even cheap sets. If you have one, take a look and see for yourself.
You've seen these before. To many, they're nothing more than a black rubber donut. But in reality, every inch has been carefully engineered, including the tread.
If you go back 80 years, tires were loud and harsh sounding, and one surprising cause is from the tread pattern used back then. You might notice the tread blocks are of similar size and shape, and aligned in a grid, which causes them to hum at one frequency. This would sound a lot like driving over a metal grate. This can be seen as a large peak on the sound spectrum, and it's no different than playing one note on a xylophone. To fix it, scientists wanted to spread out this sound energy, flattening the peaks into white noise. One of the earliest patents in 1935 started addressing this issue. It staggered the tread block so they don't hit the ground at once, which can greatly reduce noise. It also broke up this uniform pattern into small, medium, large sizes and changed the shape so each section sounds differently. That resulted in a quieter tire, but you could still hear three distinct and annoying sounds. And the cause is because the tread block pattern was not randomized well. The tire starts with 7 blocks labeled B, followed by a small block A, then 6 medium-sized blocks C. Looking at the full pattern, you see how there's not much variation, which causes noise. On modern tires, tread blocks are organized into groups called base pitches. On this tire, there are 3 pitches labeled large, medium, and small, each with different lengths and a different sound profile. This is often done by stretching the tread blocks to the length needed to change the pitch. Then, the order around the tire is randomized, and when compared to the older pattern, the difference is noticeable. This pattern improvement greatly reduces sound peaks and results in a more pleasant sounding tire.
This is called pitch sequence engineering and is just the surface of a larger ecosystem of parts below that most people have never seen. Each component plays an important purpose, but I'm gonna focus on the body plies, which are the fabric cords that give a tire its strength.
Before the 70s, most tires used bias design, which layered these plies at 30 degrees and applied the rubber tread on top. The problem is these layers rub together, generating heat and use more fuel. This wasn't a problem in America until the 1973 oil crisis caused gas prices to rise nearly 300%. The solution was the newer radial construction, where each ply layer looped around the tire, which runs cooler, using much less fuel, and quickly became the dominant design. As well, several protective belt layers are added over the plies, which protect against objects puncturing the tire. This radial design also separates the tread from the sidewall, which keeps the tread flat and stable as you turn your car. In comparison, the old bias design has the plies wrap around the tire, which connects the tread and sidewall together. This can pull the tread off the road during cornering, which reduces traction. As well, these sidewalls are stiffer, which causes a harsher ride as they are less able to absorb shock. For those reasons, radial tires are used in nearly every car and truck tire on the road today, and a huge improvement from 50 years ago.
However, engineering isn't only used to improve safety. I discovered a sneaky way tire companies cut corners without being discovered. To explain, you need to know about sipes. These are small slits that help remove water and improve traction on snow.
The problem with sipes is they flex under load, which can mean squishy handling and faster wear. One of the best ways to improve stability is to use narrow, 3D interlocking sipes that hold the block together, but this is harder to make and costs more money. For example, the tire mold, which shapes the rubber, would use thinner, geometrically complex blades, which require advanced design and 3D metal printing to manufacture.
However, there's a way companies can use a simpler and cheaper sipe without anyone knowing.
First, you remove the 3D shape. Then, to stiffen the block, you only make the cut go halfway through. When new, the tire performs great in tests and it costs less money. The problem starts as the tire wears down and the sipes start disappearing, even though a lot of tread is left. You can see this exact issue with the budget tires I bought. The old one has far less water-removing features and it still has a ton of tread life remaining. When it rains, this increases braking distance versus a better-made tire, which can cause an accident and kill people.
Most people have no idea when buying tires, as the biggest reviewers like Consumer Reports and Tire Rack only test new tires. This should change, and I want to share a fascinating story of how the IIHS shamed automakers into creating better cars.
The Insurance Institute for Highway Safety is a nonprofit and tasked with continuously improving crash safety. In the 90s, only full frontal crashes were conducted through the government's Traffic Safety Agency. IIHS thought it wasn't demanding enough and in 1995 created an offset crash, which showed how bad some vehicles were made, like this van, where the driver would have been killed. Over time, manufacturers improved their vehicles, and in late 2011, cars appeared safer than ever. IIHS wasn't satisfied, and in 2012, the small overlap crash test was launched, which simulated hitting a pole or the front edge of a vehicle. This is a far more difficult test compared to before, and once again showed dangerous flaws in many vehicles as the impact forces didn't contact the usual crash structures, which means all those forces would collapse the passenger compartment and could drive your head into the pillar due to sideways forces. You'd see how many cars went from being safe to suddenly being far more dangerous overnight. This forced car makers to improve the safety of their vehicles, as the IIHS has shown that consumers notice the test ratings and go out and buy more of the safer vehicles.
I'm hoping this idea of making tests harder can be used to draw attention to how worn tires perform. But let's move on. I want to turn our attention to a quiet revolution in tire machines. As with other industries, there's increasing automation as product complexity and labor costs grow. For better or for worse, machines are coming, and this shop is no different. For example, this tire changer makes putting a tire on a wheel simple, but it wasn't always this easy.
Tires used to be put on by hand, which is physically challenging and time-consuming. Over the years, different mechanical contraptions were created to make this easier, like whatever the heck this does. As motorized versions were created, these became the standard in many shops today, with optional time-saving devices like tire lifts, mounting hooks, and arms added for especially busy shops. The top-of-the-line machines have gone one step further with automation, which allows one tech to change more tires in less time versus older systems, and simplifies the process to allow a 10-year-old to use one.
I figure I can do that too, right? Luckily, I have an expert who will show me the ropes. Let me introduce to you Kelvin, who at 24 runs and manages this high-end tire shop called Markham Alignment, and he's a master of his craft. Shall we get started?
Yeah, Andrew, let's get started.
First thing we want to do is we want to line up this valve to this roller. You want to press the rotating button. All right, now we want to line up this roller to this part of the lip
right.
of the wheel. So in order for us to do that, we have the red joystick.
All right.
It's like a video game. We just kind of move it up and down like this.
Oh yeah, left goes right slowly.
Yeah, so it is lined up right now.
Okay.
And then that's good.
So the reason we did that was to tell the machine where the tire pressure sensor is to avoid damaging it and where the tire begins so we can start taking it off.
We can do demount, and then all you have to do is press on that go pedal.
The machine can do all the next steps by itself as it breaks the bead and pulls the tire off the wheel. The red plastic head prevents the metal hook from scratching the rim.
Wow, I'm doing it.
And then all you have to do is grab the tire so it doesn't fall off.
And I take my foot off the pedal.
Yep.
And, whew,
and then
that's
we
heavy.
Just put it on the ground.
I almost dropped this too.
This was a ton of fun, and I left out a lot of details, like explaining how balancing and tire alignment worked, as I didn't think it would fit this video. What I took away is the craftsmanship needed to do a great job and a greater appreciation of how important a tire is. Let me talk about the future of this channel. You should expect more videos like this one. I'm no longer doing any dashcam reviews, which is what I did for the last 7 years. After the success of the last video with Mark Rober shouting it out, I'm all in. It won't just be cars. I want to get into topics like great dental tools and farm equipment. Subscribe if you want more videos like this one. Big thanks to Kelvin for letting me film. If you're around Toronto and need tires or alignment done right, check out Markham Alignment. Link in the description. One last shout out to NordVPN for being the sponsor of today's video, and supporting them helps support me. YouTube thinks you'll like this video next. Let's see if they're right. Thanks for watching.